Let's take another look at prime factorization, this time with exponents. So you've got prime factorization of a number. A prime number is that's the counting number that only has two factors, itself and one. Counting numbers which have more than two factors, such as 6, whose factors are 1, 2, 3, and 6, are said to be composite numbers. Composite number, written as a product of all of its prime factors, we have the prime factorization of the number. There's several different methods that can be used for prime factorization. So, if we wanted to find the prime factorization of 78, we could use division. And then, so this is a little different approach than we did last time. If we have 78 here, we think about what 78 is divisible by. 78 is divisible by 2, and 78 divided by 2 is 39. Then we take this 39, and then we divide it again. What is 39 divisible by? It's divisible by 3. And then so 39 divided by 3 is 13. So our prime factorization and our prime factors of 78 are 2, 3, and 13. And then so at that point, because 39 is not a prime number, 2, 3, and 13, so that's our prime factors of 78. And then so our prime factorization is 2 times 3 times 13. As you see here, when we use the division method for prime factorization, we have that prime factorization of 40. And then so we take 40 and we divide it by prime numbers like 2. 40 divided by 2 is 20. We take that 20, we think of another way, another division fact, and we know that 20 divided by 5 is 4. Remember, this has to be prime here. 4 isn't prime, so we have to keep on going with our division method. And 4 is divisible by 2, because 4 divided by 2 is 2. Now each of these here, 2, 2, 5, 2, those are the prime numbers here. So that's the prime factorization of 40. 2 times 2 times 2 times 5, or 2 cubed times 5, just another way to write that. And again, these had to be in order. And let's think, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 5 is 40. 2 cubed times 5, prime factorization of 40. As we stated before, another way to figure out prime factorization of a number is to use a factor tree. And so this here's that same number, 78. 78 breaks down to 2 times 39. 2 is prime, so it comes straight down. And 39 breaks up into 3 and 13. So our prime factorization again is 2 times 3 times 13. Here's another factor tree, and this is for 84. It got shifted over a little. 84 breaks down into 2 and 42. 2 comes straight down. 42 breaks up into 2 and 21. And 21 still needs to be broken down because 21 is not prime. It breaks down into 3 and 7. Then it asks you, what's that prime factorization? And this time we're going to make sure to use exponents. So we've got 2 squared, 2 times 2, times 3, times 7. And remember again, with the prime factorization, it has to go in order from smallest to biggest. So we could use a factor tree. There's another factor tree for you. All right, it's time for you to try. I want you to go ahead and find that prime factorization of 54. And I want you to do it in two ways, with a division, using the division method, and using a factor tree. Hit pause and go ahead and try that. In the division method, we make sure to divide by prime numbers. And then so we have 54 divided by 2 equaling 27. 27 is divisible by 3, which equals 9. And 9 is divisible by 3, which equals 3. And if we look at those prime numbers there, 3, 3, 3, and 2, that's our prime factorization for 54. Which is 2 times 3 to the third power. For our factor tree, much the same way. Let's look at it a different way. We can choose the fact 3 times 18. 3 comes straight down because it's prime. 18 breaks down into 9 times 2. 3 and 2 come straight down. because they are prime, and 9 is 3 times 3, and it's just the order there. 3 times 3 times 3, 3 cubed again, times that 2, and that's the prime factorization with the factor tree, 454. Now your answer might have looked a little bit different, in that you might have chosen a different fact, but your prime factorization in either method is going to be the same. So again, we had talked about exponents. And in talking about exponents, we said it's another key idea in writing the prime factorization of a number. An exponent tells how many times the base is used as a factor. You try, if given this factor tree, 472, you try, take a look at this here, which is the lowest level of our factor tree, see if you can write that prime factorization with exponents. Pause that video, you try. If we take a look at our lowest level of our factor tree, you'll notice that we have 3 twos, so it's 2 to the third power times 3, and how many 3s do we have? 2, so our exponent there is 2. Now if we read this, this is 2 cubed times 3 squared, and again they had to be listed in order. This here is our prime factorization for 72. Our original number, with exponents. Factor trees don't always look the same for the same number, but the final answer is the same. So we might have chosen different things to begin with for our factor trees. On one, these on the left, we had chosen 8 times 9 to begin with, but it's still going to break down in much the same way. We continue to break them down, and you'll notice all those numbers in red are those primes. So we end up with that prime factorization, again, of 2 cubed times 3 squared. The order might not look the same there, but when we're doing prime factorization, we'll use those exponents, and we'll start with the smallest one, and then we'll go with the bigger one, and that we're looking at the bases for those exponents. Now, prime factorization can also be used to find the greatest common factor. And then so what we do is that we find the prime factorization for both of those numbers, 72 and 84, to find that greatest common factor for 72 and 84. And then so if we look at this here, this is 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 3, and this is 2 times 2 times 3 times 7. The prime factorization of those. What it has in common is the 2 and a 3. 2 and a 3. And then so at that point, if we multiply those 3 together, 2 times 2 times 3 is equal to 12. And so it's right here. You take that common prime factors of each number and multiply them together to find the greatest common factor. From the previous screen, we had the greatest common factor, I abbreviated GCF, as 2 times 2 times 3. 2 times 2 times 3 is 4 times 3, which is 12. Now here, I'm going to list you those factors of 72 and 84. We know that 1 and 72 are factors for sure. We know that 1 and 84 are factors for sure. We know that 2, because they are both divisible by 2, 2 goes with 36 here, and 2 times 42 goes right there. Now, are they both divisible by 3? Answer to that is yes. 3 goes there, 3 goes there. Corresponding factor with 3. I'll go ahead and write those in. I've written those in. And then we look at 4. And I'll write those corresponding factors, if it applies. Both of those numbers are not divisible by 5. 6 goes with 12, because 6 times 12 is 72. 84, however, let's see, 84 goes with, 6 goes with 14. just a few more factors to list. We know that 7 here goes with 12. 72 is not divisible by 7, though. And then we know that 8 goes with 9. And then we'd be done there. This one is not divisible by 8, nor is it divisible by 9, nor is it divisible by 10, nor is it divisible by 11. And so we've listed all of our factors for 72 and 84. Now I'm going to go ahead and circle those ones that are common here, the common factors. 1 is a common factor of all numbers there. 2 is a common factor there. 3 is also a common factor. 4 is a common factor. 6 is a common factor. There's an 8 here, however, there's no 8 here. There's a 9 here, no 9 here. There's a 12 here. And so 12 and 12. As you look at those rest of those factors, 18, 24, 36, 72, we don't see 18, 24, 36, or 72 listed here. This is also that importance of finding factors and also listing those factors from least to greatest. We're going to find out later on why finding this greatest common factor is so important. Now, the greatest common factor of 72 and 84, then, 12, 12. That's the greatest common factor. Would it have been easier to find 2 times 2 times 3? I think so. That there is prime factorization for you. What I've done now is I've written out that prime factorization for both of those numbers. This is the prime factorization for 84, and you see what they have in common again is 2 squared here. So 2 squared here, and then 1 more 3, 1 more 3. So 2 times 2, 2 times 2, times 3, greatest common factor.